Good evening and welcome to the LaSalle International Circuit in Doha. Welcome to the Qatar Airways Grand Prix of Qatar as the start of an historic MotoGP World Championship season is finally here. The lights are on, ready to star under the stars. A season opener that comes with so much anticipation and expectation. We're just over 100 days since Pecco Bagnaia won back-to-back Premier Class titles in Valencia. The Italian goes in search of an historic hat-trick. Jorge Martin, second in the World Championship last year, so close to defeating Pecco Bagnaia. The Martinator on pole as he looks to go one better in 2024. The perfect way for Martin to announce his championship challenge this season. Pole position and the sprint win on a Super Saturday for the Spaniard. Lights out and we are racing here in Doha. Van Nuys now trying to fight Thronbinder into turn two for P2. Whoa, close! Van Nuys comes out the better of it, up in a second.
And straight onto the back of Jorge Martin as the world champion goes straight into the lead.
Bagnaia means business on the first lap. The message loud and clear in Qatar, catch me if you can, as world champion Pecco Bagnaia takes the first win of this 75th anniversary season in the MotoGP World Championship. Jorge Martin does hold off Marc Marquez late on for the final place on the podium. Over 2.5 laps to go here in Portimao. Bagnaia with a proper rear guard defensive action here, which has been broken. Marquez goes in. Both gone down. Oh, unbelievable. The number one of Bagnaia and Marc Marquez in the gravel at turn five. A major, major talking point then, right at the back end of this Portuguese Grand Prix. You could write a book, couldn't you, just on the last three laps alone here in this Tissot Grand Prix of Portugal, which is being won by Prima Pramac Ducati star. It's a race win for Jorge Martin, and he is the world championship leader in MotoGP once again.
There's a crash, it's Pecco
Bagnaia, and it's on the last lap. What a blunder by Bagnaia here in Barcelona in this unforgettable sprint. It was crashed out of the lead.
Jorge Martin must feel he has got out of jail.
Look at the edge grip, and here he goes into turn five, which ended his sprint victory hopes here yesterday. So with 5.5 laps remaining here in Barcelona, it's Pecco Bagnaia that returns to the front of this Grand Prix. What a bounce back for Pecco Bagnaia. He wins a Catalan Grand Prix.
Jorge Martin strengthens his championship position in second.
Yeah. Fantastic. Fantastic. There he goes. Yeah, that's payback turn five. You're not getting the better of me.
That's what he thinks of turn five.
Can I open him? Can you believe it? How many times have we seen this? What a gift. He loses the German Grand Prix
and
he loses
lead.
The championship lead. Wow. Pecco Bagnaia, take a bow. He gets a gift here in Germany. He wins for the fourth race in succession here in 2024. And that is Grand Prix win number 24 in MotoGP. Ducati's most successful rider in their history. Taking that accolade away from Casey Stoner, the Australian legend. What a swing that is in the World Championship. The gap down to under a second between Bagnaia and Martin at the front.
Yeah, it took 3 or 4 laps for Bagnaia to get into his groove, but he certainly has now. And now he's gone down, right on cue. The world championship leader down, and that might now change hands back to Jorge Martin.
Does anybody want to lead or win this MotoGP World Championship this year? Jorge Martin does settle for second after he pays for another late mistake. Doesn't pay his costs, what he did a couple of weeks ago in the Saxon Ring. Pecco Bagnaia just did not have the late race pace at all. He took the checkered flag third.
But the World Championship lead has been lost this weekend by the reigning world champion.
Lights out and we are racing in the sprint here in Austrian Spielberg, and Pecco Bagnaia has got the drop on the field.
Martin straight back at the inside of Bagnaia for the lead.
Well, here comes Bagnaia on the inside. He goes. That's a good launch, a good raid on the inside of Martin. He's in a little bit hot though. That's two or three overtakes we've had for the lead already on this first lap. It's going to be back in the hands of Martin. They go side by side once again on the brakes into 2A. And Martin getting in a little bit hot. He's way hot. And this will allow Bagnaia surely to sweep back into the lead. He has to lose a second in this sector. There's Martin. He slots in behind Bagnaia. Just one corner left then for Pekka Bagnaia. He said he had to sort out his sprint Saturdays here on Thursday, and it has been job done from the world champion. Pekka Bagnaia steals the headlines once again in Spielberg.
Certainly didn't give Martin problems getting off the line this time, did he? He kept the lead from Pekka Bagnaia, but for how long can he keep it? Bagnaia wants it straight away as they hit the brakes for the first corner at the start of lap two, and Pekka Bagnaia takes the lead of the Austrian Grand Prix.
Martin has attacked. We'll go down the side road real quickly. Martin attacked briefly on the inside of Bagnaia into turn nine, running a little bit wide. Bagnaia just hugged the inside line. It is more glory in Spielberg, more glory at the Red Bull Ring for Pekka Bagnaia. He takes the double here in Spielberg. He is now your outright leader in this year's World Championship. He's taken down the world champion. That is a huge controversial moment in this year's MotoGP World Championship. That is one of the most significant talking points of this year's MotoGP World Championship. Another second place for Martin, but he now is in complete control of this year's MotoGP World Championship. It's lights out and we are racing in MotoGP here in Misano. The rain is now at its heaviest of this Sunday race day here. Martin's putting his hand up. I think they're just letting their teams know here. They're coming in. Of course, they can't stop the race. It's flag to flag. Is Martin sending a message to his team that he's going to come in? He certainly is. That was the clear message. So Martin has rolled the dice then. He has come into pit lane. He's seeing Pekka Bagnaia. Bagnaia has carried on. So has Bastianini. So has Binder. So has Miller. So Hoi Martin, the world championship leader, is the only rider who has decided he's seen enough, too risky, too dangerous. Martin in for the wet bike. Pekka Bagnaia, who takes 20 points out of Hoi Martin in the championship chase. Bagnaia's got down. Pekka Bagnaia has crashed out of third place. Can you believe it? And that feels like the biggest plot twist of them all so far. There's going to be several more twists and turns in the championship.
Jorge Martin has really boosted his world championship challenge today, taking advantage of the crash of Bagnaia.
Jorge Martin's crashed out on lap one. Does anybody want to win this year's MotoGP World Championship? This could be Martin's world championship advantage slashed in half. He comes through the final corner and there is another massive twist in Mandalika in this year's championship battle as Pekka Bagnaia does take the checkered flag first. Bagnaia is your winner. Jorge Martin takes the checkered flag in 10th. No points for the rider that's still in the World Championship, but of course he will be left to rue another nightmare in Mandalika. Jorge Martin, he is the master of Mandalika. And he seizes back control of this year's MotoGP World Championship. Vamos is the message on the 89's pit board as he takes a monumental victory in this year's MotoGP battle. What a launch away by Jorge Martin. He has got the drop on the field.
That was a very good start by Jorge Martin. I just hope from his point of view, it wasn't too good. It looked borderline to me.
He's gone wide though into turn three. They go side by side. They rub elbows, do the top two riders in the World Championship. You can hear the roar of the crowd. They are on their feet. Martin closes the door on Bagnaia going into turn four. And now Martin's off the circuit. Big, big mistake on the front end then into turn three. We follow Bagnaia then now. He is still fighting tooth and nail for this third MotoGP World Championship. Bagnaia wins here in Buriram. Mathematically now, we have just two title contenders remaining. Just two left standing in the race for glory in the 2024 MotoGP World Championship. And it is now 17 points in favour of Martin. still very much game on.
Like and subscribe for more MotoGP action. What are you waiting for?